Hi friends, as time is nearing for prelims examination, you no need to write the answers for these questions. Just you can look at the question, brainstorm the answer, think of few points and look at my answer so that you can compare, so that you will be in touch with the mains answer writing, as well as it will be slightly relaxing for you from your preparation for the prelims. And I hope you are writing mock tests for the prelims, and those who are writing more number of mock tests, it is time that you stop writing the mock test. At least last 4 to 5 days, no need to write much of the mock test. So today we will discuss the answer for question number 36 that I have given yesterday. It falls under General Studies Paper 1. In General Studies Paper 1, you may be knowing that we have World History and also Post-Independence History. So this question is a combination of both those. So the question is saying that in the last two decades of 20th century, a lot of events happened in the world that actually influenced India deeply. This is the question. So they're asking you to discuss this. See, in the last two decades of 20th century, a lot of things happened globally. But definitely you cannot write all of them. So think of some 5 or 6 major events that really impacted the Indian economy or administration or international relations, whatever, and try to explain only those things, because the question is only for 10 marks. So in these kind of questions, you have to use the concept called touch and leave concept. I think I already explained you the touch and leave concept. Anybody who wants to see that now can go to question number 12 and 13 to see that. So friends, the introduction, how do you introduce for these kind of questions? You can say that the last two decades of 20th century is a kind of watershed. It's a watershed in the world history, and a lot of changes happened in the governance, administration, international relations, economy, trade, politics, terrorism and several other aspects, and they had impact not only on India but throughout the globe. This is the type of introduction I would rather prefer. Now, so you can also say, let us see some of those events and how they impacted India. And as I told you, you can go back to mains with Sarath and see question number 12 and 13. In that, I explained in detail what is touch and leave concept. In this concept, you will address each issue, but you will not discuss them in detail. You just touch them and leave them. So first, let us take international politics. What changes happened in the last two decades of 20th century? See, for example, Berlin Wall fell down in 1991, means where East Germany, West Germany united, and USSR broke down into several countries. That also happened in 1991, precisely December. So till then, we have got the bipolar world where USA and Russia in USSR are two poles. But after USSR broke down, USA is a single power. So it became unipolar. So in this context, there is no meaning for NAM. Non-alignment movement was the concept introduced by Jawaharlal Nehru because he does not want the developing countries to align either with USA or with Russia. That's why he has done that actually. So now the non-aligned movement became irrelevant, or maybe not irrelevant, better you write the word less relevant. It became, never say anything is irrelevant, particularly Indian concepts, okay? It became less relevant. In fact, India tried to align with everyone, align with USA, with Russia, the Western countries, as well as the communist countries. So we believed in multi-connectedness, a new concept. Means you have to maintain relations with all the countries. Instead of staying away from powers, you stay close to all the powers. So because of that, the relationship with India, the relationship of India with the Western countries, not only USA and European countries, but also Australia and New Zealand, relations with Western countries has actually improved. And with Russia, our relation has changed. See, Russia actually almost became equal to India. Right now, for example, India is number 5 in GDP. Russia is, I think, 11th in GDP, the whole GDP ranking. So almost India and Russia became like equal powers. So our equation with Russia has changed hugely. And also, in another direction, China has started growing rapidly. China, its economic model has changed, and China started growing rapidly. So India's relationship with China also changed. This is regarding the politics. So as I told you, you no need to explain them. Just mention one line and leave it, touch and leave. another major thing that happened in World Trade Organization formed in 1992, I think, 1992 or 94. In that time only, the last decade of the 20th century. As the World Trade Organization has formed, the international trade actually has improved. Globalization actually increased. India is integrated. India's economy and trade is integrated with more number of countries more deeply. In fact, in 1991-92, during the time, as India faced the balance of payment crisis, we approached International Monetary Fund and IMF helped India, but asked India for liberalization, privatization, globalization. That's why India implemented the new economic policy by which we globalized more. We opened our economy. Private sector has increased. Foreign direct investment has increased. FII has increased. So a lot of change happened in the economy. Also, India previously used to stay as a socialist economy. Now we became a mixed. Now most political parties accepted for the mixed economic model. However, though we say it's mixed economic model, crony capitalism has shown its ugly head in India too. A certain top capitalists of India, because of their ability for political funding, they started ruling the politics of India to some extent. So crony capitalism also entered into India, though we tried to follow a mixed economic model. These are the changes. This is the influence that India had because of that formation of WTO and the IMF rules, etc. The another aspect is IT revolution. Though information technology, computers started in the 1960s, actual revolution happened only in 1980s. So India at the time started encouraging this new industry called IT industry. It's a sunrise industry, IT industry. India encouraged it. India framed a good policy. India created a good environment for IT industry to grow in India. So India adopted it. Because of that, in a very short time, India became a superpower in providing IT services. Not IT products, but IT services. IT services. In fact, India is number one in the global IT services. And because of that, several Indians went abroad to serve the clients. Because of that, the remittances into India has increased. These remittances helped India to develop economically. And India is able to establish soft power across all these, these USA, Australia, all these countries. India is able to establish soft power because many Indians have started IT companies across the world. Also, IT companies are able to create more employment for women, which industries are unable to create. Manufacturing sector unable to create women employment, but this IT industry is able to create. Also, the lifestyle of the people changed because the salaries are more. They became more professional. And communication with the West has increased because our clients are Western people. So these are the influences India had because of IT revolution. Now let's come to the negative side. Actually, Taliban formed in almost 1994. Taliban formed, and Taliban controlled almost half of the Afghanistan at that time. And because of Taliban, Pakistan actually got more power. Pakistan in fact became a terrorist country. Because of that, the cross-border terrorism in India increased. See, I am telling you what happened globally and how it affected India. The Taliban's effect on USA, that we should not discuss. We have to just mention in the last two decades what is the main thing that happened globally. And we should specifically mention their impact on India only. Don't try to mention their impact globally. Okay. So India, that is why India started procuring more defense equipment. Previously, we used to get only from Russia, but later with Israel, from Israel, from France, from USA. USA, Israel, France also became like great suppliers of defense equipment to India. Now, administration front. Take the administration side. Let us discuss what happened in the administration side globally. See, the concept of good governance is introduced by World Bank in 1992. And India is no exception. India also started adopting to the good governance principles. Actually, good governance, if you have time, you can quickly draw a diagram. The PABAT students will be drawing that. For example, good governance, concept of transparency, equity, equality, or equability, accountability. You draw the diagram given by the World Bank for good governance. Responsiveness, transparency, accountability, equity, equality, or equability, or more factors. You can draw the diagram for the good governance. Then friends, because of good governance, what happened is gradually the license raj ended. Previously, the permission licenses for every industry are more. Because of globalization and also for transparency and good governance, license raj almost stopped in India. Transparency increased in India. For example, later on in 2005 and all, Right to Information Act came into India as a part of good governance. Social auditing is introduced in India in several sectors. So actually this good governance concept influenced Indian administration deeply. So in fact, you can write more. You can write about China, you can write about the Africa-India relations, you can write, but I want to stop it here because I addressed 4 to 5 concepts. So you can conclude in any way. For example, I would rather conclude by talking about culture. Then what happened globally actually affected India's language, food habits, clothes. For example, you know, the English education increased in India. Coming to food habits, the McDonald's chain, the KFC chain, you know, the food habits actually increased. Cross-cultural food habits, the Western food habits increased in India. Clothing also, jeans started wearing, youth started wearing jeans, other latest Western styles, Western fashion has become common in India because of more globalization. So you can say India is deeply influenced, even culturally, India, because of global village, you see, it's a global village concept. India is deeply influenced by the happenings across the world. In that we can conclude, friends. And the question for tomorrow, General Studies Paper 2, International Relations. The question is about China. As China, after 1990, China started growing rapidly, friends. China actually, its economy increased almost some 10 times between 1990 to 2020. So whatever relations China has at that time with India and USA, right now they're changing. Because of this, do you think a new Cold War is starting? That's the question. Try to answer it. See you, friends. Take care.